today on this national conference advanced in video, cyber learning and electronics, we are going to launch a new optimization technique called as snake prey optimization technique. The buffalo snake, it is actually mimicking of buffalo snake prey hunting. How they are taking up the foraging? Foraging is nothing but getting up, searching for food, getting up the food. The foraging concept is saying of that one, maximize the ratio of E by T. So in this one, the buffalo snakes were shown in Discovery Channel. They are available in Amazon region. Now, we hope that snake prey optimization is going to be a new addition to the family of evaluation competition, which was invented by the others, which was not at all existed till today. If you are seeing the present existing scenario of existing optimization techniques, there are different optimization techniques already available. One is artificial neural network, the second one is genetic algorithm, the third one is swarm intelligence. In that one, ant colony optimization and particle swarm optimization, both are available. And the third one is germ intelligence, which is also called as bacterial foraging algorithm. So regarding of this, you are pretty well about the fact that in artificial neural networks, we are getting up the error to be minimized. We have to repeat the iterations, number of iterations continuously, making of the computational cost very much high. Hence, the people are slowly shifting over from the theoretical mathematical computations to bio-inspired algorithms, which are coming under the category of genetic, swarm, and germ. So if we are comparing of those things, so this is a brief comparison of our algorithm, which is known as SPOT, snake prey optimization algorithm, or with other bio-inspired algorithms. Here we have taken the number of parameters such as population, number of operators, computational time, accuracy, system efficiency, speed of convergence, and understandability. If you are seeing of this one, genetic algorithm in the other case, ant colony optimization in PS, particle swarm optimization and bacterial foraging optimization also, in all these cases, depending upon the problem, the number of population is increasing. And the number of operators in GA, we know that when there is over selection of more operators, crossover mutation, all these things are very much high. And in ant colony optimization, it is somewhat less. It is nothing but phenomenon and probability. And in PSO, there will be only one operator, which is known as a velocity modulation operator. If you are seeing of this one, computational time in GI, which will be very much high naturally, since more operators are there. In ACO, it is somewhat less than GI, but it is also more. In PSO, it is less. It is already, so many papers are already published. It is PSO is used for faster convergence. And, but in accuracy, if you are saying of that one, in GA it is very good and it is already proved its stubbornness since long back for complex problems also. And in ACO it is moderate and in PSO it is good. And but PSO is also having a suffering. It will have the faster convergence, but it will always have a trap in the local minimum. So for avoiding of that one, so many methodologies they were invoked, and they were, and for avoiding of that one, Newton technology was PSO was came over in ACO was came over in 92, and PSO was came over in 95 by Herbert and Kennedy, and later BFO was came over by Pacino, and which is giving of accurate solutions. It was invented in 2002. And in SPOT, we are getting a very accurate system efficiency. In system efficiency, if you are seeing of this one, in GS, due to the number of operators, the efficiency will be decreases, and ACO is also decreasing, PSO is somewhat good. So the people are basically interested in the speed of convergence and the accuracy. If you are seeing of that one, speed of convergence in GI is slow, and ACO is good, and PSO is very fast. And if you are seeing of the understandability, GI is understanding of a person like a layman of mind. It is very complex. In ACO, it is simple, seeing only two operators are there, probability and phenomena. And the second one is PSO, it is very simple. Feeling discomfort. And BFO, it is complex since there is chromatisis, elimination, dispersal, swimming and tumbling. So how these things are moving, no one is able to understand what it is doing inside of it. By keeping of all these things, we want to mimic all the silent features and tremendous effects of the entire algorithms which are already existed over now, until now, today in this present scenario. The basic feature of all these things is nothing but we want the population should be very much less. The second one is the number of iterations must be less. The third one is the number of accuracy must, the accuracy must be more. The fourth one is computation speed should be low. And we have to get the exact result which should be compared with the published one. When we are compared with that one, the SPOT, which is also known as snake pre-optimization, we are using of only one population, which is very much innovated. Less than one, there won't be any population. So next one, number of operators. You know that when comparing in all these algorithms, PSO is having up only one operator, so we have adopted that one. Here also we are using up only one operator. We want only always least things, but we want the better result. So the third one is computational time. When we are comparing with the, not only concentrating about the population and operators, we want the accuracy also and computational time also. The computational time should be very much less. And accuracy, very accurate. System efficiency. Since it was, the computational time is reduced, efficiency was increased, and speed of convergence is also very fast since it is having of only one population. Understandability is very easy. So how it is working? The snake prey optimization, just now we told that one, it is a mimic of buffalo snake search for prey. So prior to doing of this one, we have thoroughly investigated what it is doing, how it is searching for the food. There are two things. One is whether the prey should come to the snake or the snake should go to the prey. These are the only two alternatives. Now the first case, those are the basis of that one. Our principal basis, here there are two things. One is discrete and localized. The preys are in different areas. Those are in discrete areas. The prey will, due to its probabilistic nature, it will sense where the preys are available. It will run for a longer distances. And in general, the literature survey says that one, that snakes are, lifespan is only 12 to 15 years. And now, after doing in this one, they are having of, they will always, due to its, their probabilistic nature, they will search for the prey, they, wherever the preys are available, and they are going over there, and they are waiting for their prey to come over, and they will catch over, which is nothing but, in the Pasno's work, it was already given as an ambush search. Now, the second one is localized. Here the snake won't move at all. It will stay over there and the preys are coming over near to its domain. So we have taken both the alternatives in discrete optimization and localized optimization. Now when we have, for doing of this optimization technique and different standard fitness functions. Here we have chosen of validation. Here the validation of SPOT was done on standard benchmark functions, which is one is known as Rosenbrock function, the second one is Rasmussen function, the third one is Greenbank's function. For this one, what we have done is, initially we are making of the snake positions and velocities are random. We were chosen like that. Since where it was available, we ourselves doesn't know. And when we have simulated, these are the results we obtained. In the first one is nothing but a plot of domain for Rosenbrock's function. It's nothing but a domain or area where the search, where the prey snake will searches over the region for getting of the prey. And depending, we have already told that one, depending upon the arrival of the prey, the sensation of the snake will be continuously changing over. In general, it will be in random in nature. When the prey is coming nearer, its sensation increases in very much higher level. So if you are seeing that one, these are the plot of sensory levels in Rosenbrock's function. And the maximum sensory level means the prey is coming very much nearer to the snake. Basing on this one, and we have done this, and whenever we are here, the thing is, the sensory levels are nothing but getting of accurate values. So when we are making of the simulation, we are also considering of the boundary conditions of Ahmed Shami. And treating of that one, whenever in PSO, there is always one problem escaping of the boundaries. So when the velocity is continuously, iterations are continuously increasing, they will always escape, tries to escape from the velocity in the respective domain. So for making of them to be restricted within the domain, what we have done is we have made the maximum velocity should be confined within the search space. So in the first case, when we are doing of that one, this is the output of that one plot of snake position and velocity for Rosenbrock function. It is not able to escape from the boundary. When we are doing of the optimization, after here we have done 100 iterations for 10 trials, overall 1000 fitness evaluations. This was repeated multiple times. You might have been observed, this is the only plot where we will get a continuous average global best of constant level. The values are below level of 10 to the power of minus 3. We will also show that result. But in general, all the plots for Rosenbrock function is slowly decaying from the higher level to the lower level. But you can see from the, when we are doing a continuous, we ourselves were also puzzled in such a way that one, why it is coming like this? It should be slowly decreasing. But when we are observing of this one, since it is having of always stable position, depending upon higher sensory levels only, it is getting off. So, and it is minimizing in the initial position itself and getting of the accurate positions of 10 to the power of minus 3 millilevels. And we have taken the cutoff level as 10 to the power of minus 6, that's why the graph was shown like this. So next one is, the same thing was repeated even for rastering function. If you are seeing of the Grebank's function, in all these cases, the values are very much puzzled. And if you are seeing the actual values of this one, you can observe this. For the F1 function, which is in the Rosenbrock function, this is 1.0 e to the power of minus 4 into 0.404. Time elapsed is only 2.4333 seconds. It's a miracle. No one was done until now. So F2x, here we have taken the, we know that one, the fitness functions should be evaluated in the number of dimensions, multiple dimensions. So that's why we are continuously varying the dimensions also. Here the number of dimensions initially was taken, 10, 15, 20, and like this. And the time elapsed was also changed over. And then the next one is, we are also wanting to apply this one for image denoising. If you are seeing of this one, here we have taken a actual LINA image, which is having a 512 by 512 image. And it was here, since due to the time lapse, here it was downsampled for 30 by 30 size. And it was mingled with salt and pepper noise of 90%. Now, I have applied both BFG and bacteria foraging optimization and snake prey optimization. We know that when bacteria foraging optimization will give the accurate result. This is the restored image after applying a BFO. Elapsed time is 17.44500 seconds. The PSNR peak signal to noise ratio is 53.6130. When we have done with SPOT, the restored image after applying SPOT, elapsed time is 8.74300 seconds. Since the basic difference is here the population is only 1. That is the basic difference. And the PSNR, even the 53 is matching. Here it was improved, you can see here. 53.8378. So as per this results, we can evidently say that one, that prey will take, spot will take very much less time for computational. So people are wanting of only two things, accuracy and computational effort. Both the things are satisfied through this, through our optimization technique. Hence, in this paper, the authors are introduced a novel and new technique named as snake prey optimization technique SPOT, which is mimicked from the behavior of buffalo snake life cycle and has not been developed by anybody except the authors as on today, for giving of me this opportunity to evolve this new technique. And the SPOT is a simple, robust, probabilistic, which is nothing but a probability in nature. So BFO is basically probabilistic and deterministic in nature. So we have taken that one. We have adapted the simpleness of velocity operator and we are able to produce the accurate results. The results show promising improvement in the accuracy. Well, drastic reduction in computational time. Thank you, Anandas.